This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Maxine Moore Waters Ney Carr, born August 15, 1938, is the U.S. Representative for California's 43rd Congressional District, and previously the 35th and 29th districts, serving since 1991. She is a member of the Democratic Party. She is the most senior of the 12 black women currently serving in the United States Congress, and is a member and former chair of the Congressional Black Caucus. Before becoming a member of Congress, she served in the California Assembly, to which she was first elected in 1976 as an assembly member. Waters advocated for divestment from South Africa's apartheid regime in Congress. She was an outspoken opponent of the Iraq War. Waters was charged, and exonerated, by the House's Subcommittee on Ethics with violations of the House's ethics rules in 2010. Contents: 1. Early life and education. 2. Early political career. 3. U.S. House of Representatives. 31. Elections. 32. Tenure. 33. Rodney King verdict and Los Angeles riots. 34. Castro and Cuba. 35. Racial politics. 36. Government spending. 37. Haiti. 38. CIA. 39. Iraq War. 310. International lending. 311. Mandatory minimum sentences. 312. Criticism of the Tea Party movement. 313. Allegations of corruption. 314. Committee assignments. 315. Caucus memberships. 4. Personal life. 41. Other achievements. 5. References. 6. External links. Early life and education. Waters was born 1938 in Kinlick, Missouri, the daughter of Velma Lee Ney Moore and Remus Carr, fifth out of 13 children. Waters was raised by her single mother. Once her father left the family when Maxine was 2, she graduated from Vashon High School in St. Louis, and moved with her family to Los Angeles, California. In 1961, she worked in a garment factory and as a telephone operator before being hired as an assistant teacher with the Head Start program at Watts. In 1966, she later enrolled at Los Angeles State College, now California State University, Los Angeles, and graduated with a sociology degree in 1970. Early political career. In 1973, she went to work as chief deputy to City Councilman David S. Cunningham Jr. Waters entered the California State Assembly in 1976. While in the Assembly, she worked for the divestment of state pension funds from any businesses active in South Africa, a country then operating under the policy of apartheid, and helped pass legislation within the guidelines of the divestment campaign's Sullivan Principles. She ascended to the position of Democratic Caucus Chair for the Assembly U.S. House of Representatives elections upon the retirement of Augustus F. Hawkins in 1990. Waters was elected to the U.S. House of Representatives for California's 29th Congressional District with over 79% of the popular vote. She has been re-elected consistently with at least 70% of the popular vote in the California's 35th Congressional District after significant parts of the pre-1990 29th California Congressional District were folded into the newly defined 35th California Congressional District when California gained 7 additional seats in the House following the 1990 United States Census. Tenure. Waters represented a large part of south-central Los Angeles and the Los Angeles coastal communities of Westchester and Playa del Rey, and the cities of Gardena, Hawthorne, Inglewood, and Lawndale on July 29, 1994. Waters was challenged for remarks made during the House Banking Committee's Whitewater hearings denouncing Rep. Peter King, with whom she had argued the night before. She said, "Men and women, the day is over when men can badger and intimidate women." Waters was chair of the Congressional Black Caucus from 1997 to 1998. In 2006, she was involved in the debate over King Drew Medical Center. She criticized media coverage of the hospital, and in 2006, Waters asked the Federal Communications Commission FCC to deny a waiver of the cross-ownership ban, and hence license renewal for KTLA-TV, a station the Los Angeles Times owned. She said that the Los Angeles Times has had an inordinate effect on public opinion and has used it to harm the local community in specific instances. She requested that the FCC force the paper to either sell its station or risk losing that station's broadcast rights according to broadcasting. To defend station holdings at a minimum, defending against one would cost tens of thousands of dollars in lawyers' fees and probably delay license renewal about 3 months. Waters' petition was ultimately unsuccessful as a Democratic representative in Congress. Waters was a superdelegate to the 2008 Democratic National Convention. She endorsed Democratic Senator Hillary Clinton for the party's nomination in late January 2008, granting the New York senator nationally recognized support that some suggested would make big waves. Waters later switched her endorsement to send Barack Obama when his lead in the pledged delegate count became insurmountable on the final day of primary voting. Waters had a confrontation over an earmark in the United States House Committee on Appropriations with fellow Democratic Congressman Dave Obey in 2009. The funding request was for a public school employment training center in Los Angeles that was named after her in 2011. Waters voted against the National Defense Authorization Act for fiscal year 2012 as part of a controversial provision that allows the government and the military to indefinitely detain American citizens and others without trial. With the retirement of Barney Frank D. Massachusetts in 2012, Waters became the ranking member of the House Financial Services Committee on July 24, 2013. Waters voted in favor of Amendment 100 included in H.R. 2397, Department of Defense Appropriations Act of 2014. The amendment targeted domestic surveillance activities, specifically that of the National Security Agency, and if ultimately passed would have limited the flexibility of the NSA's interpretation of the law to collect sweeping data on U.S. citizens. Amendment 100 was rejected 217-205 on March 27, 2014. Waters introduced a discussion draft of the Housing Opportunities Move the Economy Forward Act of 2014, known as the Home Forward Act of 2014. A key provision of the bill includes the collection of 10 basis points for every dollar outstanding mortgages collateralizing covered securities, estimated to be approximately $5 billion a year. These funds would be directed to three funds that support affordable housing initiatives, with 75% going to the National Housing Trust Fund. The National Housing Trust Fund will then provide block grants to states to be used primarily to build, preserve, rehabilitate, and operate rental housing that is affordable to the lowest income households, and groups including seniors, disabled persons, and low-income workers. The National Housing Trust was enacted in 2008, but has yet to be funded. Rodney King verdict and Los Angeles riots. When South Central Los Angeles erupted in riots, in which 58 were killed, after the Rodney King verdict in 1992, Waters gained national attention when she helped deliver relief supplies in Watts and demanded the resumption of vital services. Waters described the riots as a rebellion, saying, "If you call it a riot, it sounds like it was just a bunch of crazy people who went out and did bad things for no reason." I maintain it was somewhat understandable, if not acceptable. In her view, the violence was a spontaneous reaction to a lot of injustice. In regards to the looting of Korean-owned stores by local black residents, she said, "There were mothers who took this as an opportunity to take some milk, to take some bread, to take some shoes." President Bill Clinton to return him at once to Cuba. Racial politics in 2001, Waters called Los Angeles Mayor Richard Reardon a plantation owner. During the LA riots in 1992, Waters described the violence as a spontaneous reaction to injustice. She held economic, social, cultural, and political factors responsible and that the riots should rightly be called a rebellion or insurrection. Waters co-sponsored Rep. John Conyers' bill calling for reparations for slavery to be paid to black Americans. Government spending. This article includes a list of references, but its sources remain unclear because it has insufficient inline citations. Please help to improve this article by introducing more precise citations. July 2014. Learn how and when to remove this template message. In September 2011, Waters called for the implementation of a federal jobs program of $1 trillion or more. "We've got to put Americans to work," she said. "That's the only way to revitalize this economy. When people work, they earn money, they spend that money, and that's what gets the economy up and going." Haiti. Waters opposed the 2004 coup d'état in Haiti and criticized U.S. involvement following the coup. Waters led a delegation to the Central African Republic along with Transafrica Forum founder Randall Robinson and Jamaican Member of Parliament Sharon Hay Webster to meet with Haitian President Jean-Bertrand Aristide and bring him to Jamaica, where he would remain until May. CIA. Following a 1996 San Jose Mercury article alleging the complicity of the Central Intelligence Agency CIA in the Los Angeles crack epidemic of the 1980s, Waters called for an investigation. Waters questioned whether U.S. government paid or organized operatives smuggled, transported, and sold it to American citizens. the United States Department of Justice DOJ announced it had failed to find any evidence to support the original story. The Los Angeles Times also concluded after its own extensive investigation that the allegations were not supported by evidence. The author of the original story, Gary Webb, was eventually transferred to a different beat and removed from investigative reporting. Before his death in 2004, Mr. Gary Webb was found in his apartment with two bullet holes in his head. His death was declared a suicide following these post-publication investigations. Waters read into the Congressional Record a memorandum of understanding in which former President Ronald Reagan's CIA director rejected any duty by the CIA to report illegal narcotics trafficking to the Department of Justice undeterred, Waters told the Los Angeles Times in 1997, it doesn't matter whether the CIA delivered the kilo of cocaine themselves or turned their back on it to let somebody else do it, they're guilty just the same. Iraq War. Waters voted against the Iraq War Resolution, the 2002 resolution that funded and granted congressional approval to possible military action against the regime of Saddam Hussein. She has remained a consistent critic of the subsequent war and has supported an immediate troop withdrawal from Iraq. Waters asserted in 2007 that President George W. Bush was trying to set up by continually requesting funds for an occupation that is draining the country of capital, soldiers' lives, and other resources. In particular, she argued that the very economic resources being wasted in Iraq were those that might provide universal health care or fully fund President Bush's own No Child Left Behind education bill. Additionally, Waters, representing a congressional district whose median income falls far below the national average, argued that patriotism alone had not been the sole driving force for those U.S. service personnel serving in Iraq. Rather, many of them needed jobs, they needed resources, they needed money, so they're there. In a subsequent floor speech, Waters told her colleagues that Congress, lacking the votes to override the inevitable Bush veto on any Iraq-related legislation, needed to better the administration's false rhetoric about the Iraq War and educate our constituents the connection between the problems in Pakistan, Turkey, and Iran with the problems we have created in Iraq. A few months prior to these speeches, Waters became a co-sponsor of the House resolution to impeach Vice President Dick Cheney for making allegedly false statements about the war international lending in August 2008. Waters introduced H.R. 6796, or the Stop Very Unscrupulous Loan Transfers from Underprivileged Countries from Rich Exploitive Funds Act, also known as the Stop Vulture Funds Act. This would limit the ability of investors in sovereign debt to use U.S. courts to enforce those instruments against a defaulting country. The bill died in committee. Mandatory minimum sentences. Waters opposes mandatory minimum sentences. Criticism of the Tea Party movement. Waters has been very critical of the Tea Party movement. On August 20, 2011, while at a town hall discussing some of the displeasure that supporters of President Obama have had with the Congressional Black Caucus not supporting the president, Waters stated, "This is a tough game. You can't be intimidated. You can't be frightened. And as far as I'm concerned, the Tea Party can go straight to hell." Relatives had made more than $1 million during the preceding 8 years by doing business with companies, candidates, and causes that Waters had helped. They claimed she and her husband helped a company get government bond business, and her daughter Karen Waters and son Edward Waters have profited from her connections. Waters replied that they do their business and I do mine. Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington. Crew named Waters to its list of corrupt members of Congress in its 2005, 2006, 2009, and 2011 reports. She was accused of using her position to prevail upon officials to meet with One United Bank without disclosing that she and her husband had significant stock holdings in the company. Since she was on the Financial Services Committee, she largely had the role of determining where TARP funds would go. $12 million in TARP funds went to One United without her ever disclosing that she had a financial stake at the company. Citizens Against Government Waste named her the June 2009 Porker of the Month due to her intention to obtain an earmark for the Maxine Waters Employment Preparation Center in 2010. Waters came under investigation for ethics violations and was accused by a House panel of at least one ethics violation related to her efforts to help One United Bank, where her husband had been a director and in which he had stock holdings, receive federal aid. Waters' husband is a stockholder and former director of One United Bank, and the bank's executives were Major contributors to her campaigns in September 2008, Waters arranged meetings between U.S. Treasury Department officials and One United Bank, so that the bank could plead for federal cash it had been heavily invested in Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae, and its capital was all but wiped out after the U.S. government took them over. The bank received $12 million in Troubled Asset Relief Program TARP money. The matter was investigated by the House Ethics Committee, which charged her with violations of the House's ethics rules in 2010. On September 21, 2012, the House Ethics Committee completed a report clearing Waters of all ethics charges after nearly 3 years of investigation. Committee assignments: Committee on Financial Services, Ranking Member Subcommittee on Capital Markets and Government-Sponsored Enterprises, Subcommittee on Insurance, Housing and Community Opportunity, Subcommittee on Oversight and Investigations. Previously, she had served on the Committee on the Judiciary Caucus Memberships, Chief Deputy Whip, Founding Member and Chair of the Out of Iraq Caucus, Member of Congressional Progressive Caucus, Member of Congressional Black Caucus CBC, past chair of CBC 105th United States Congress. Personal life: Waters resides in the Hancock Park area of Los Angeles, which is approximately 6 miles west of downtown. Her second husband, Sid Williams, played professional football in the NFL and is a former U.S. ambassador to the Bahamas under the Clinton administration in 1990. Waters, along with 15 other African American women and men, formed the African American Women for Reproductive Freedom. Other achievements: Maxine Waters Preparation Center in Watts, California, named after her while she was a member of the California Assembly, co-founder of Black Women's Forum, co-founder of Community Build, received the Bruce F. Vento Award from the National Law Center on Homelessness. References: Carrot A. B. Lipton, Eric, July 31, 2010, Ethics Inquiry on Waters is Tied to One United Bank. The New York Times. And All U.S. Companies That Are Doing Business in or With South Africa. Carrot McConnell, Bill, September 19, 2004, Your Money or Your License, Broadcasting. International Business Times. Convocation on February 20-January 15, 2007, Currents UC Santa Cruz. Carrot Maxine Water, PBS. Carrot Aristide Says U.S. Deposed Him in Coup d'Etat, CNN, March 2, 2004, retrieved May 6, 2010. Whiteout, The CIA, Drugs and the Press, Verso, ISBN. Carrot Jenkins, Sally, August 22, 2011, Maxine Waters to Tea Party, Go to Hell, The Washington Post. The 11th of July 2009. Carrot Hederman, Rosaline, September 21, 2012, Maxine Waters cleared of House ethics charges. The Washington Post retrieved the 21st of September 2012. Appearances on C-SPAN. Articles: Los Angeles Times interview, Maxine Waters by Robert Scheer, LA Times, May 16, 1993. Top Blacks, Maxine Waters, Distinguished Congresswoman, 2001 profile. Maxine Waters speaks with Street Gangs Media by Alex Alonso, www.streetgangs.com, January 18, 2003. Haiti regime neither able nor willing to hold fair election by Rep. Maxine Waters, October 19, 2005. Beyond delay, Rep. Maxine Waters, DCA, criticism from Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington. United States House of Representatives proceeded. Succeeded. Joe Bacca, member of the U.S. House of Representatives from California's 43rd Congressional District. 2013 present incumbent. United States Order of Precedence ceremonial proceeded. Senators Dianne Feinstein, D. Barbara Boxer, D. Representatives ordered by District. Doug LaMalfa, R. Jared Huffman, D. John Garamendi, D. Tom McClintock, R. Mike Thompson, D. Doris Matsui, D. Ami Barra, D. Paul Cook, R. Jerry McNerney, D. Jeff Denham, R. Mark DeSaunier, D. Nancy Pelosi, D. Barbara Lee, D. Jackie Spear, D. Eric Swalwell, D. Jim Costa, D. Mike Honda, D. Anna Ashu, D. Zoe Lofgren, D. Sam Farr, D. David Valadeo, R. Devin Nunes, R. Kevin McCarthy, R. Lois Capps, D. Steve Knight, R. Julia Brownlee, D. Judy Chu, D. Adam Schiff, D. Tony Cardenas, D. Brad Sherman, D. Pete Aguilar, D. Grace Napolitano, D. Ted Lieu, D. Xavier Becerra, D. Norma Torres, D. Raul Ruiz, D. Karen Bass, D. Linda Sanchez, D. Ed Royce, R. Lucille Roybal Allard, D. Mark Tacano, D. Ken Calvert, R. Maxine Waters, D. Janice Hahn, D. Mimi Walters, R. Loretta Sanchez, D. Alan Lowenthal, D. Dana Rohrbacher, R. Daryl Issa, R. Duncan, D. Hunter, R. Juan Vargas, D. Scott Peters, D. Susan Davis, D. Other states delegations: Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, California, Colorado, Connecticut, Delaware, Florida, Georgia, Hawaii, Idaho. Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana, Maine, Maryland, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Montana, Nebraska, Nevada, New Hampshire, New Jersey, New Mexico, New York, North Carolina, North Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming, non-voting, American Samoa, District of Columbia, Guam, Northern Mariana Islands, Puerto Rico, U.S. Virgin Islands, V.E. Current members of the United States House of Representatives. Presiding Officer, Speaker Paul Ryan. Majority Party, V.E. Current Republican Party Conference. Majority Leader, Kevin McCarthy. Majority Whip, Steve Scalise. Other members, Abraham Adderholt, Alan Amash, Amade Babin, Barletta Barr, Barton Benishik, Bilirakis M. Bishop, R. Bishop Black, Blackburn Bloom, Bost Bostony, Brady Bratt, Bridenstine M. Brooks, S. Brooks, Buchanan, Buck, Bouchon, Burgess, Byrne, Calvert, B. Carter, J. Carter, Chabot, Chaffetz, Claussen, Kaufman, Cole, C. Collins, D. Collins, Comer, Comstock, Conaway, Cook, Costello, Kramer, Crawford, Crenshaw, Culberson, Curbelo, Davidson, Davis, Denham, Dent, DeSantis, Desjarlais, Diaz, Ballard, Dole, Donovan, Duffy, J.D. Duncan, J.J. Duncan, Elmers, Emmer, Farenthold, Fincher, Fitzpatrick, Fleischman, Fleming, Flores, Forbes, Fortin, Barry Fox, Franks, Frelinghuysen, Garrett, Gibbs, Gibson, Gomert, Goodlatte, Gosar, Gowdy, Granger, G. Graves, S. Graves, T. Graves, Griffith, Grothman, Guinta, Guthrie, Hannah.